I want to take this opportunity to talk to you straight about the action the government is taking on the economy. I know you will be anxious about events of the last few days and weeks and worried about the impact on your own family or business. In the last few days, I've been meeting mothers who are worried about household bills, pensioners anxious about the cost of heating, young people who want to buy their first homes but just can't get a mortgage at the right price. And I've also talked to small businessmen and women who look to banks to get them the cash flow that they need. I've said we'll do whatever it takes to help people through these tough times, and that's what we're doing. The bottom line is that if we don't take this action to help stabilise the banking system, the cost to savers, homeowners and small businesses would be far higher. The banking system needs cash to function. Without it, it too would seize up and break down. Imagine the situation if the banking system fails or banks simply stop lending. Businesses would go to the wall and families would really suffer. So we're taking this action to reform the system now, not to help banks as an end in itself, but to help savers and businesses and support the health of our economy through these challenging times. The United Kingdom government is leading the world in taking bold and far-reaching action at home and abroad. The decision by the UK, US and other countries to cut interest rates is an important signal that the international community is prepared to take coordinated action. These are global problems which require global solutions. That's why we will take in the next few days the stability and restructuring programme we have announced for Britain to the rest of the world. And let me tell you about the three main steps we're taking in Britain. First, to address the immediate problems, the flow of money between banks. The Governor of the Bank of England is extending loans to high street banks of at least £200 billion. Secondly, to ensure the long-term health of the British banking system, we're offering to support banks in raising additional capital by the government investing directly in them up to £50 billion. We, the bank and the regulators, are determined that UK banking should be strong and it should be secure. And thirdly, for a commercial fee, we will provide guarantees to allow banks to raise their own money in the markets and to resume normal lending. In this way, we expect to provide at least £250 billion of guarantees, money that will earn us a return. All these are investments being made by the government, which will earn this proper return for the taxpayer. And this will allow banks to return to their basic function of providing cash and investment for families and businesses, and so help the economy move forward. These decisions are the best way of providing long-term security for savers, and we are showing by the many actions we are taking that we stand by people who save in Britain. At all times, we will ensure taxpayers' money is protected. As you will expect, there will be strings attached, conditions laid down to the support we give to banks. We will need to be satisfied that the banks are lending to homeowners and businesses, including small businesses. We will insist on bank credit lines to small businesses being maintained on a normal commercial basis. You should know that the measures we are taking are not at the expense of better public services. Our commitment to our investment in schools, hospitals, and into ensuring fairness is as strong as ever. And we are helping elderly people with their heating bills at this difficult time and helping get the housing market going again with special help for people who have mortgages. And we are providing, of course, a £120 tax cut during the course of this year for basic rate taxpayers. If you're a saver, a homeowner, an entrepreneur, a family struggling to get by, I want you to know that we are doing this for you. If families are going to have mortgages, if families are going to be able to access cash, if businesses are able to invest, they need a banking system that is sound. That is why we are engaging in this restructuring of the British banking system. And I can assure you that this government will carry on doing whatever is necessary to take us all through these difficult times.